An Academy. Let's crack it.
Hello students, welcome to this, the most awaited session, which I think me or many of the CA aspirants were waiting for, who has scored All India first in this Jan 21 attempt. And in fact, we have got a series of questions. Many questions have been given to me to put forth to Vishal, for which I have selected some of those questions, and accordingly I will try to put forth those things to Vishal, and I hope that the next half an hour, 45 minutes would be the most value addition, productive and the inspirational program and interview for all of you. First of all, Vishal, a heartiest congratulations. This is
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Indeed,
Vishal, this is a huge success. So like AIR one, it's a really, and that too in CA final, it really makes like the, it's way above many people that dream it. Many CA students will dream it, and you have indeed have achieved it. So Vishal, first of all, just let me know on that day of the result, what it all went through on that Sunday, the D-Day, what all happened.
Thank you very much, sir, for your research. It feels great to connect with you. On the result day, result was supposed to be declared on Sunday. I thought generally they will declare an afternoon by one or two. The results were not declared by one. I thought again by evening it would be declared. Again, it was not declared. By seven, I thought that, okay, the result would be declared only on Monday. And then I started going, visiting the site itself. And then at 9:30 or 9:45, I just checked the site. The results were declared. And then I entered the roll number. And I saw pass on both groups. I felt very happy. I didn't even see the totals and all those on max and internal subject. The sync pass itself is very great in CA final.
Please go ahead.
And then I felt very happy. And then I called my family and friends, and then informed them, and they also felt very happy.
So your family and friends, like you are where? You are in Chennai.
No, I'm in Chennai right now.
And family and, friends and all.
And I am from Nepal, so my family are in Nepal. I called them and then I informed them. They were also very happy.
No, that's a really great, good news, students. I think I suppose 2 years back, or say one student from intermediate, if I'm not mistaken, he was also from Nepal. He was
already one. Sir.
He was in intermediate.
Yes, sir. No, sir, it was an intermediate case code one from
all India. Okay. So that was an intermediate Nepal student. So those who are from Nepal, there, that was intermediate CA one for the first rank, and now we have got Vishal CA final rank one. So how come, like, from Nepal to Chennai, what was this this journey all about, and why Chennai?
Actually, a person who was already a CA at that time introduced me to this career, and then he actually did CA from Chennai, so he made an arrangement to stay in Chennai, and then I came along with him. He introduced all these courses, and then I stayed here and I continued this.
Okay, that's so good. So like for last 4 years you are in Chennai, that is what we can make it out.
Yes, sir. From last 2015 I've been staying in Chennai.
Okay, 2015, so good five to six years now.
Nice.
So Vishal, I think now you have already given a brief journey here, and maybe you can just tell us quickly 2 points, like why you have selected CA as a course, like what was the option, why you have selected as a CA?
I was I selected CA because the various professional opportunities which are available to CA and the future further studies which we can do after becoming a CA. That's why I selected CA.
Okay. So, and like, what was the articleship at all? How did you, which, like, where exactly you did it all?
I did articleship in Chennai itself, from a Chennai-based firm, PMR Info. And then I got a great exposure in articleship, which helped me to clear in AI. That's what I can say.
Okay. And like, here, like, you were already like in your previous level foundation intermediate. What was this like score? You know, you were a rank holder earlier.
No. This is my first rank. The first in earlier.
So students, this is again a great particular news here. In fact, All India One now, Vishal. Yesterday, Vishal, I was interviewing Vaibhav Hariharan. He was All India second rank in the new course. So in fact, he also scored All India second rank for the very first time. So now you are also a student. This is what it is. I always say that many things in life happen for the first time. And nothing can be so better and so sublime to get an All India One or even a rank at CA final level for the very first time. So that was so excellent. Like, it was great. You expected a rank after the examination got over?
During the preparation stage, I did not focus on any rank. I just was doing my normal studies. Normally, like, how I would study, I was studying normally. And exams, I started giving exams. Once the exam, all the exams got over, exams went great. And then I thought some around 10 or 15 or 20 rank I would, but I didn't expect AI one.
Okay, so you were having a bit of this thing, that intuition that maybe chances are very high this time that you would be ending up getting a rank.
Yes, sir. I was expecting some rank, maybe some 10, 15, but not AI one was unexpected.
And like, when you saw that AI one primarily, what made you saw that AI one? You said that the result at the time of result you have saw you were passed both the groups.
Yes,
after that, when you checked your rank status,
actually in the institute site, institute did not publish merit list for old syllabus. Actually, they published only for new syllabus. And then I thought, like, they discontinued for old syllabus all the merit list. So I thought, okay. And then after 1 hour, I started getting messages. And then I thought, oh, who is doing all this rank and all? I could not believe at first. And then I saw. Then I saw the place release. And then I thought, okay, so I got first rank.
So it was after the messages that you got it that you realized that you actually are a rank holder. And
yes, sir,
I suppose you never have got a call from the president this time, maybe because it was a Sunday.
Generally, I'm sorry, I didn't get any call from
president. Yeah, because generally the ICR president gives a call. And this time, maybe because Sunday and all, he would not have
given a call. That result came very late, sir, around 9, 10. That
could be the reason. So, Vishal, like, can we like go through your final examination preparation strategy? How much leave that you have taken when you started off? And like, can you
I took around 5 months leave, and then during the 5 months strategy, I used to prepare like multiple subjects I used to take in a day. At least 3 to 4 subjects I used to prepare. Like how I prepared in IPC, the same way I prepared in finals. I used to prepare 3 to 4 subjects a day. And then I used to in the same normal, I prepared in the normal way without any to clear the exam. And that
You are having an attempt in May 2020 or November 2020? What was the first?
May 2020.
Okay, May 20. So around December, you have taken the leave.
No, so actually, this is not my first attempt. So I started. My first attempt was May 19. And then this Sunday.
But here, then so first attempt was May 19, and thereafter.
Yes, sir.
Now, tell me one thing. This is important. First attempt, like, what was the issue? Like, where you got stuck in first attempt?
First attempt, I could not clear law and indirect access. So I got stuck.
Okay. And then the second item, November 19?
November 19, I could not write due to various reasons. I did not even appear for that.
Okay.
And then I thought like, okay, we'll do everything in May 20. I'll clear in May 20. And then all again, COVID started, the exam postponed. Went to November 20. And I opted out from their thinking because being away from family itself is a big thing in during these difficult times. And then I thought, let the COVID get somewhat controlled, and then I opted out for them. And then in January.
So Vishal, one thing which I want you to, because this is a very important thing. This is actually, I should say, that from a failure to success, and that to such AIR1, this is actually makes you, it is not about that you got AIR1, you got AIR1 because of this particular factor that you couldn't clear and then you ended up getting AIR1. Vishal, first of all, can you just share that obviously when you would have seen your May 19 results at that time, you would have been disheartened a bit in terms of not clearing the exam, isn't it? So how you have picked up yourself, how you have regained your composure and that made yourself a promise that this time I'm going to make it. What exactly went through?
I identified my weak areas. So in subjects which I could not clear, I started from those subjects itself. And then I prepared those subjects very thoroughly. With other subjects also, I gave equal importance. And then from there, I self, and whenever I used to feel demotivated, I used to see the results. And then again, I used to prepare and the same. And then I felt like I don't want to repeat these results again. That's what I used to.
So you're, in fact, again, like whenever you were getting off the track, you used to see the result. And that result that you couldn't pass, that made you focus again and strive harder to achieve your goal. Students, see, this is such an important part for all of you because many of those who could not make it, please don't get disheartened. Here is AR1 in front of you. This is how he has picked up himself. And this is what he has become out of it. So what is important is what you become out of failure, students. This is the real character. And I can vouch that these person really will go very far because it is not about the failure. It is about the way you react to that failure that defines the person that you are. And Vishal is a classic example that is there in front of us, how he has picked up itself. Student, this is what is really, I'm saying Vishal, because this is what is the inspirational stuff. So hats off again. And students, again, see this, he has picked up this thing. For him, this was an inspiration that if anytime he was getting off the track, he will go and see that this is the result that I got. Let me not do it again, the mistake, and let me, in fact, study very hard. So Vishal, what is that, like in that case, like maybe from July 19, when the results were out for May 19 attempt. After that, your journey was what? Like you completely have closed yourself to studying, disconnected with the outside world. What was that?
After exam, I completed my article 6. And then I went home. I went to Nepal. And then I stayed for around, took a break because everything was going on at the article sleep and then exams. Like I was tired, mentally, I was very tired. So I wanted to take a break. That's why I could not write November 19. And then I came back after 45 days. And then I again started studying. That's what my plan.
Okay, then when you started studying, like how was the life after that? You joined any articleship firm thereafter or?
No. Only 6 months were left for me. And then I didn't join any articleship. I was fully in this
school. Okay. Yeah. 6 months was there. So it was fully. And what was that? How you were finding some time to be connected with the outside world or like you have completely isolated yourself?
No, sir. I believe like there should not be only studies. You can do everything. Or even while studying, I never deactivated any social media. I used to go outside or even use social media, but I used to limit time, maybe 15 to 20 minutes per day. I used to give time to social media, all the social media. So I didn't disconnect to the outside world. So I was doing everything all together simultaneously.
Friend, this is an important thing. One thing is that although he was connected with the social media, but very importantly, he regulated himself. Like what he said was 15, 20 minutes. So that he was very clear as to what he was doing. He was investing his time. He was not spending his time. He was, in a way, was investing. Like if he was, I suppose that if supposedly, Vishal, you were connected to social media, it was just for the seeking any updates and information, the new stuff which are being there. I think that was the reason why you would have been connected to those things, isn't it?
Yes.
So students, this is again an important takeaway. Never let your time slip away. Just to otherwise what happens is that social media makes you engaged and you never know how that time flies out. So just regulate yourself. Yeah, that's what Vishal said. And in fact, even Vaibhav said the same thing, that they were in fact connected with social media, but they had complete control on themselves. 15, 20 minutes, whatever limited time that they would give, they will definitely will give it to that thing. Now, Vishal, let's come with the subject by subject. There's preparation. Can you just go through the marks that you have got it first, and then we can take across the subject strategy? What was the marks that you got in this exact attempt?
By subject wise, or how?
Yeah, subject wise.
In FPAR, I scored 60 exactly. Okay. And SFM 76, audit 60, and law 51. That's okay. In group one, and in group two, it is AMA 51, ISCA 74, 51 in BT, 56 in AG.
Okay, so I think so. Can you now tell us subject by subject how you have dealt with, like, starting with FR? And considering what you can advise to all the students and all.
First thing is regarding, for old syllabus, I think only one attempt is there. So, FR is completely new and is completely different in new syllabus. Yeah. I think advise all the old students to give it a hard work, do as much as you can, because only one attempt is there. And you should not need any other attempt. So you clear with this attempt itself everything what you need to clear. So regarding FR, you need to practice. FR is comparatively easier. So I think you need to practice and solve at least, solve the institute material should be done for FR. That's what I used to do.
Okay. Any typical tip that you can just share, like something that you had something in mind in FR that this really works? Some a bit of tip kind of a thing.
And as far as what a student normally should do is, there are various easy topics that should be done, okay? Because in FR, even 60 or 70 we can cross by doing those topics. Because it's not like all FR is, because certain topics are there and which are almost asked in all exams. I think these topics should be completed first. And then the remaining topics will be done. And and if you're stuck in the middle, I think you should continue. If you're stuck in the middle, if you don't do any treatment and all regarding for any adjustment, you can make an assumption and go with that without considering whether it will be right or wrong. Read the answer or write something. That's what I need to say.
How about SFM, Vishal? SFM?
Regarding for SFM, I think institute has practice manual, study materials are there, and some past papers, 3 to 4 past papers also should be enough. Because these are not updated in practice manual every year. So those papers should be done separate. That's what I used to do.
Any special tips like in SFM also, apart the way you have said about FR?
Regarding SFM,
SFM was a very tough attempt for November. I said one new or old, I'm not aware, but it was some very tough attempt.
Paper. It was tough for me, sir. It was very tough for me.
Yeah, new paper, would you have, no?
Yes, sir. It was very tough for new syllabus. What I think in SFM there are multiple formulas. I think those formulas you need to revise at least one day before during that 1 point. So because if you do not know formulas, you cannot even proceed. I think you need to revise the formulas, and while practicing, you need to mark the different types of questions or the adjustments which are different and which are not covered in other types. So you need to mark that, because practicing everything one day before examination is not possible. So only market difficult, it's super difficult, and then practicing those questions will be the one day.
Student, this is again an important point, that at least mark the typical adjustment or maybe some typical problem which is very new, which you think that you want to do it a day before examination, so that everything is sorted out. There is no confusion on the day before examination. So ensure that you make a markings or make a note of it, so that those things what you have decided to refer a day before examination should be there in front of you. Perfect. Auditing is a scary subject to many of the, I think this of lately, auditing has become a very talk about subject because of some reasons students are not in a position to do well.
Right.
What is your strategy, like what you will suggest to the students?
I think three subjects, like for two subjects, theoretical paper like auditing and law. These are theoretical subject as compared to other FRSS, MGCE, IIT. I think this needs regular revision. That's what I follow, sir. For law and audit, I need to make regular revision. At least one day, each subject should be studied. Maybe it's a small topic, but every day it should be studied. And then you need to remember, try to read as much as from institute material directly, because suggested answer will be framed on the basis of institute material itself. So you can directly refer the institute material and make certain things can be made like with the help of mnemonic or anything which you feel remember, feel easy to remember. That's what I use.
So Vishal, in auditing paper, now this paper has become like a threat. Means many students are finding it really very difficult on auditing paper. Now, how you have tackled this particular paper? Because one part of the students is that it is very vast. And secondly, is that they don't know where they are going wrong. What is your advice for all the students to prepare for auditing paper?
Regarding audit and law, since audit and law are theoretical papers, kind of theoretical papers as compared to FR and SFM. So, and it requires a regular revision, maybe at least for 1 hour each. There should be revision of law and audit, and they're doing a regular interval. And the students should can create their own summary notes, and like, either by writing or can underline in the main book itself which they are referring to. In this way, they can create a summary notes, and they can also make various mnemonics for various terms, for various points that they are finding difficult to remember, or can relate to the various objects or images or pictures so that they can remember it for a long time. And while preparing for answer, they can frame the probable question. They can prepare themselves what would be the probable questions, and for which this answer will be written. They can frame the probable question, and on the basis of that, they can prepare this theoretical paper like law and audit. And they need to also know what to write and how much write, because writing everything for one question may not, for time may not be sufficient to answer all the questions in such manner. And then for, they can compare suggested answer and their answer. That's what like is for audit. And
so here, I think very important point that Vishal has said was about the fact that frequent revision students has to be done. These two subjects here specifically have earmarked that we have to do a frequent revision because of the fact it's a theory. He has said that very clearly. And I also agree that if you compare even out of the 8 paper, these 2 papers are actually very, very much theoretical. It is not theoretical in the way that it is like they will ask you what is this and what is that. But comparatively, it is a theoretical paper. And very correctly, he has said it that frequent revision is what will help. So please ensure that there is not big gaps. Small gaps are there. As he said it very correctly, select the topics, try to revise it, but be in touch with the subject. So the gap should be very less. Frequent revision is what he has said it. In fact, he has said, I think Vishal, daily basis, you are taking one subject, audit and law, for revision purpose?
Daily basis, at least one should be taken daily, because otherwise we'll forget it very easily. And retention is also equally necessary in these topics, because we may not be able to revise everything the day before exam. So now itself, we need to have a mindset that we need to retain it for a longer time. That's what I used to say.
Very true, very true. And one particular part in group 2, primary, ISKA, you have scored 71.
74, sir.
How much?
74.
Because I'll tell you, I just want in this particular group 2, how you have prepared, because this is the last attempt. Yes, and sir, many students have not cleared in ISKA this attempt.
Yes, sir.
And they've given me the marks also. So please tell the strategy, because this is the last attempt. And definitely they would want any some typical advice that you would have done for ISKA that you can really guide them for.
The ISKA is theoretical and technical. So first thing is ISKA is theoretical as well as technical subject. So, and regarding ISKA, the 2, it is the last attempt for old syllabus. And ISKA is a group decider in group 2. Either you'll go it or you need to come back. So for ISKA also, you can follow the concepts similar like law and audit. Either you need to take it on a daily basis, but don't take it for a too long time. Maybe don't take it straight away for 4 hours, because it will be too heavy to study the same thing. This is theoretical and technical topic for 4 hours. Basically, you can take one in the either in the morning or in the evening. That's what I used to do. Like if I take audit or law in the morning, I should take ISKA in the evening period and just revise it on a regular interval.
Okay. And Vishal, any paper writing that you have done it primarily because of this thing? You were in a position to complete all your 8 papers? Because many papers were considered lengthy by the students.
During examinations or something?
Paper writing, have you done earlier of the subject?
Some test series you can appear for any test series, or even the institutes, test series, 2 test series are generally conducted by the institutes. You can attempt for any test series. Is at your convenience, you can attempt and you can do like for 3 hours, what speed we need to write and what are the questions to be attempted first and what are the questions to be attempted last, and what timings will be given to each. To each question, so you need to write. We need to write at least 2 test series before going for examination. Because if you directly, the test series also gives an experience of facing in totally new questions, and so on, which is out of the box and without the box in an exam. So I think that is also very important in writing any test series.
So you have appeared for 2 test papers for all the 8 papers, or selected you've done it.
I didn't write for all the test series, but I saw the questions, like what questions were asked and whether I have read these questions or not. And if not the questions, I solved the question, I prepared for it, because sometimes in the examination, same questions is asked in the main examination. So I think if those questions, if those happens, then those questions can be solved in no time if you've already done the same in test series.
Very true. And when you are going through the 3 hours and with 15 minutes, you have an extra time. You tell me, first of all, that we'll divide it in 2 parts. One is the practical paper.
Yes, sir.
How you have, what was the selection of your questions that you did? You got 15 minutes extra. So how you up your mind, which question to be targeted first and like that, what was the process of your selection?
For the practical papers. Let's go with practical papers. For practical papers, I generally used to attempt, I used to have a quick look of the type of questions, and then it will decide whether the question is easy, medium, or extremely difficult. In 15 minutes itself, you can decide what is the level of question. And then I used to make a mindset that if the question is difficult, then I used to do it. I need to remember various concepts, maybe various interlinking might be there. And then I used to decide. And if it is a difficult question, then I expect that it may not be possible to solve all the questions. Even I expect that. If the question is extremely difficult, it may not be possible to attend 100 out of 100. So mindset was already there. That's what I used to make. And if the question is easy, I was like, okay, let's write 100 out of 100. I attempt to write 100 out of 100.
Okay, so students, that is very, very clear. Vishal already had made up his mind about the 3 type of questions, extremely difficult, or maybe manageable, and this thing, midway. On that basis, he was very clear that in any case, he is going to make an attempt for 100. Whether it is a difficult paper or it is a simple, in any case, he will make an attempt to go for 100. That is one thing which has been there. But what was the first question that you used to follow the sequence? Like question number 1, 2, 3?
I generally used to read the last question itself, because I feel like the last question will be the easiest question. So I used to read the last question directly. And then I used to read the remaining questions. That's what I follow every time.
So this option, this is very unique. So last, I think question number 6 was the last, no? Generally?
The 6 are N7, which are not in MCQ, question number 7 is the last N for other 6.
Yeah, question number 7. So you used to always read the first, last question.
Yes, sir. I always read question number 7 at first. Then I will decide the other.
And how many papers you have attempted for question, with question number 7 as of this thing? First question?
Almost all papers I started question number 7 it was. I don't know why, but I made a habit that I'll read question number 7, I'll start with question number 7.
Okay, that is very unique. And what was the second question? Then let's, so I think number 7, the last question was, we can say, a kind of a zinc.
Yes, sir.
So what was the second question that you used to attempt then?
Actually, I attempt from reverse order. I used to attempt question number 7, and then I used to, once the 7 is done, I used to go for 6, and then 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's what my...
But if supposedly 6 was difficult, then still used to go with 6?
No, I decided 5. I go like first thing, I go directly solve the questions which are easily solvable, which can be solved immediately. And then I go to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And if these are difficult, again, come back to 6 to solve that over time. In this way.
Okay. Okay. So first, like your order was question number 7. Yes, and sir. Then you should decide which is out of the remaining this thing question that you have attempted, which is an easy question. So you used to attempt that. And if question number 6 was easy, then you used to follow that particular order.
Yes, sir.
Perfect. And when was a compulsory question that you used to attend? Question number one. What point
this
of
number
time?
Number one, I used to attend somewhere in the middle.
Somewhere in the middle.
Yes, sir. After 1.5 hours or around 2 hours, I used to attend the compulsory.
Mm-hmm. So that you used to not leave it towards the end also, because towards the end it can really be very less time.
Yes, sir. Because end in a hurry, you can make the mistakes.
So, Shrun, this is a strategy. Like I, for the first time, in fact, I will also make a good analysis now. At least for direct tax, I will at least go through all the attempt paper just to see whether that last question is simple one or not. So that I will keep on advising a student this trick. Thanks to tell us this trick, Vishal. I will just see whether for DT also you did the same thing. Question number 7, you started with that.
Yes, sir. All the back questions will go slightly kind of theoretical kind of question, like in assessment or some other kind of factor. So I always go with my first will be like, once I get the question, I directly turn at the back without even reading the question. Then space number 7 or 6, I used to read, and then go from the reverse order. I always read from the reverse order.
Okay, so reverse order was your the game plan.
My students, go for reverse
my suggestion is that students just go, because this is a very unique technique which Vishal is sharing. I will suggest all our students that at least 2-3 attempt paper. I'm saying all the paper, please go through the paper, because Vishal, why I'm saying so. What you are saying to me right now, I was just doing right now MCQ and case study sessions. Right now, I'm just doing it for May 21 attempt students. So this time we are doing many MCQ and case study session. And we are finding out that 90% of the answer is C and D. Means the last particular is the C and D happens to be the real answer. This is our observation, which is about the ICI case studies and all. C and D happens to be the real answer. And the same way, as Vishal is saying, question number 7, if you go with the reverse order, the questions are easier at the end. So therefore, it is better to, in fact, just see whether the last particular questions are easier. Students, 2-3 attempt paper, at least you should go through it. Just see whether this particular, because this is a very interesting and very unique trick which can be applied. Indeed, definitely.
Regarding MCQ, you said C. And I found that many studies have shown that at C is, in fact, the real answer. If the student is not able to decide either to take A, B, C, or D, I suggest the student to take C, because there are almost like 26% chance that C is the correct answer.
This is what it is. So students, just keep this point also in mind. C would be the chances are very high. C would be your correct answer. So if there is a jackpot to be played, it has to be on. I just answer is C. So
the student is not able to decide like on any points. Like, he is blank out of completely out of mind, then the student can take C because there is no
Definitely. So if though only do this only when you are not aware knowing the solution, then this trick can be applied, because even we are concluding that the C and D happens to be the kind of a real answer anyways. So Vishal, when you actually attempted MCQ, like in which point of time, at the very start or midway?
At the beginning, at the beginning itself, I started with MCQ.
Okay. And how much time you give for MCQ, you know?
If it is a theoretical subject, doesn't require much time. On law and audit, either you know or you do not know. Hmm. But in direct access, you need to make some calculations. These may take around 45 minutes. But audit and law can be completed around in half an hour.
Some of the MCQ, by looking at the question, used to leave it. Like, for example, depreciation, some very complicated calculations are there you have to do. And you would have known that only for 1 marks, I have to do so much.
Yes, sir. There are some questions which may not be worth even time, because some questions may go really long, but the answer may be 1 mark. So in that case, the student should be wise enough to decide whether to attend this or not. That's also
Keep in mind, Shrunath. And did you encounter such question in your examination?
Yes, sir. Many times, such questions will be asked many times. So the questions might be very lengthy, but in fact, the question is only for 1 month. So the student should be able to decide whether to do it or not. So that is to say.
Please keep in mind, Shrunath,
because the time you spend on that marks may not be worth enough to spend.
This is a very important point. If it is 1 mark and the MCQ length, I think those who have done it well, practice it well, they should know easily that this kind of a calculation would be too huge for you to really justify the marks which has been allocated. Leave it. Because these are trap questions. These are the trap question students. Vishal, any paper that was not for when you got AR1, that attempt, January 21, any paper which was very bad for you?
For me, AMA paper was very bad, because the questions were extremely lengthy, and once the question once I see the lengthy questions, the questions start automatically getting difficult. Even the easier question starts getting difficult because one at the back of mind the process, like there are many questions still left to be done. So even the easier questions start getting difficult, and then at those difficult times, so I attempted so as fast as with the speed I try to attempt the question, and I did some good. So I was actually scared for AMA because the paper didn't go so well or so expected. But still, I tried to do as much as I could.
You attempted 100 marks for AMA also?
No. 100 marks cannot be attempted, sir.
How much marks?
Are extremely lengthy, sir. I 75 to 80 I could attempt.
Okay. And but still you are not sure about whether it was right or wrong.
Yes, sir, because many questions we get stuck at the middle itself and we could not reach towards the final answer, and then there will be many other questions left to be done, and so I could not attempt this AMA as much as I expected.
So now after the examination got over of AMA, your mind would be not that happy, and then how you disturbed, how you have handled that moment and ensure that your preparation for ISKCON didn't suffer because of AMA. Because this is where the students really go wrong. One paper goes bad, and that too, first paper of your group two.
Yes,
it was very high chance that you would have then dropped in your surrender this entire thing. What was that? How you have managed yourself to really appear for the next? Because the next paper, your performance 74.
What I think is, once you give in paper, forget that paper. The next paper is the first paper itself. I used to think. I gave AMA. That's once the paper is done. For me, this guy is the first paper now. AMA is done. For me, this guy is the first paper. I have not given any other exam. So this guy is the first paper. This is what I used to wait.
This thing, Vishal, tell me, used to train your course. This automatically, this thought doesn't come on the day of the examination.
Yes, sir.
This requires a bit of training. Like, you already used to always train yourself before this, like 2-3 months before that, if the paper goes tough, I'll still will attempt the next paper. Because generally what happens is that, I'm telling you, many, even though we as a faculty, if some students say, sir, I'm going to fail and all, even though we have to speak to them, the students doesn't agree. They say that, sir, we have given, we know now what you're saying to us. So what is that? Like, it requires a lot of mental toughness. So you prepared yourself earlier.
While the student must understand that there might be some papers which will be extremely tough to solve during the exam. The student should have that mindset. Not all subjects are going to be difficult. You should be prepared to face the difficult papers. That's what I used to have a mindset. There are going to be some papers which are difficult or which are very lengthy, and I may not be able to attend 100 mark paper. So that's what the mindset. And once you have that mindset, it's fine. Then it will reach the expectation. Okay, the paper was difficult, and once the paper is difficult, it's not difficult only for that student. It's difficult for the entire group of students. So it's okay, fine. Everybody may not be able to attend 100 marks, but I used to think.
Students, you have got 2 months' time, specifically for those who are appearing for May 21. Please keep reminding 5 minutes daily this particular point, because this has been the maximum problem for many of you, that the moment one paper goes down, that's it, the entire group is gone. It should not be the case. You cannot let go so easily here in this regard. And as he has said it very correctly, Vishal, that this is not for you, that it was tough. It was tough across the country. So you should not get disheartened, in fact. And in that case, and how much you scored in then AMA?
I scored 51.
That's still good, sir. Attempting 75 marks and getting 51 indeed is this particular part. So that is exactly, it is very great and very normal. Now you tell me, Vishal, because you would be the right candidate to answer this question, because you have tasted a failure once, then you bounced back and you got All India One rank. Supposingly, because many students are in this this thing. Supposing you would not have cleared this attempt also. Let's take a hypothetical question. And now you have got only 2 months. Sir. And you have got only 2 months left. Because obviously you all will be 22nd of May. How you would have now prepared for your 8 papers?
Me.
Well, time is only 60 days.
Yes, sir. Time is only. So, how I was thinking was, I'll see the results. And once I get, if I get any subjects like 30 or 35, if I get in subjects, I'll take start with that subject itself. If I get 60 or 65, 60 then exam. But if I get 55 in any subject, that subject are still good enough for the for some time. I should take in the subject which I did not do so well. Then I used to start with that chapter and give more time to such chapters or sub subjects. That's what I started. So that plan I had already made actually. Okay, even that to be on the safer side, I actually made that plan if exam did, if the results did not become favorable. My plan was to take those subjects which the marks are very less, start on those subjects with decreasing little time to the subject we have scored around 50 or 55 or 15, 7, 58. That's on my plan.
Vishal, can you share me that particular plan in WhatsApp if you don't mind? I'll share it to the students across it. Because this is very important because many students are really fearful right now. And frankly speaking, I, with a lot of students who have passed it, but many students who have not passed it also, they are also approaching us. They are only getting worried about this particular question itself, about the 60 days factor. I can definitely guide for my subject, but nevertheless for other subjects also, because you have already prepared it. Why for you it is important? Because you have really gone through that particular process and all. And it would be really be a value addition. If you can just share with me this particular plan in fair, I can just share with the students also. It would be really be helpful for those students because they are only getting worried about how do I prepare. But right now, students, those who are hearing, what is the important point that Vishal has said was those subjects that you have failed, you have performed badly, please pick up those subjects first and try to see where you have gone wrong, because obviously many of you would know the answer. And those subjects where you have scored like 50s and all 55, so that is reasonably well. That can come a bit later. So the subject which you have scored it really very less marks, please start with that immediately. Cover some good grounds. Make your weakness your strong area. And then you can come back to the other subject. But obviously you have to do a lot of good time management because you have at the end of the day only 60 days. So do a balancing job very carefully. And that would be the best particular thing in this regard. So... herein, I think this is what it is. I will not take much of your time. Any other particular advice that you can share, Vishal?
Regarding the have an honest approach. Now it's only 60 days. So give whatever you can give for 60 days. And clear in this attempt. Do not need any more attempts. Make it as the last examination. That's what I say. Like, believe in your preparations and do your best. Make it as the last attempt. So no more attempts. That's what
Very
I say.
True. Very true. And what is your future plan now?
As of now, I'm waiting for campus placement and then maybe joining a service industry for some years. That's what I mean, as of
now. Okay, so service industry as of now. And some students always want to ask, what about the herein? One student's query was there about the marriage plan and all the stuff.
Marriage plan is not yet decided. There's no plan of marriage.
So CA students, they always will remain the CA students. So this kind of a question, now the question was also, what is their marriage plan? Anyways, Vishal, again, congratulations, heartiest congratulations. You have really done not only me, but also all the people around you, your parents and all. Your parents would have been very happy, isn't it?
I'm very happy, sir. I informed them that around, it was already midnight. They were already asleep. I called them and they were very happy, sir.
And what do your parents do? They're in Nepal.
My father is a medical officer and mother is also.
And they are based in Nepal itself.
I said they are in Nepal.
That's so good. So good. You have really made them proud and all. This was a day every parent want their child to watch them, because at the end of the day, this is what everyone does it. We live for our parents. We do our effort to make them proud. And Vishal, today you have indeed done your parents really proud. It's all yours, Vishal, your hard work, your commitment. The fact that I never knew this, but you have not cleared in May 19 and you bounced back from there and got All India 1 is indeed a feat. Indeed a feat. And this, you will go a long way. Just maintain the same spirit, maintain the same character. You will go primary places. Once again, congratulations again. Heartiest congratulations. And any guidance required from my side, please do free to reach out to me. I'll be happy to assist you in any way what I can. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
God bless to you. God bless to you.
Thank you.